In this video, we will talk about mechanism of tachyarrhythmias. There are three mechanisms of tachyarrhythmias: enhanced automaticity, reentry, triggered activity. There are following cardiac structures in the pacemaker hierarchy: sinoatrial node, atrioventricular node, and His-Purkinje network. The sinoatrial node has the fastest depolarization rate. Normally, it's 60 to 100 beats per minute. The normal spontaneous depolarization rate of the AV node is 40 to 60 beats per minute. The ventricles can depolarize spontaneously at a rate of 20 to 40 beats per minute. If an impulse does not arrive at a certain part of the electrical system from an upper structure in the hierarchy, or if the depolarization rate overrides the sinus rhythm, then the lower structure in the hierarchy takes over the pacemaker function. Enhanced automaticity is a phenomenon in which certain cardiac structures depolarize faster than usual. This condition may occur due to a negative shift in the threshold potential or a positive shift in the maximum diastolic potential. Enhanced automaticity may result from increased sympathetic tone, ischemia, electrolyte disturbances, or certain drugs. Under certain circumstances, non-pacemaker cells may gain the ability to generate impulses. These cells are sometimes called dipoles. The main cause of the reentry mechanism is tissue heterogeneity. A reentry loop requires two adjacent pathways with different conduction speeds and refractory periods that are separated by an obstacle and connected proximally and distally. An impulse is conducted via the fast pathway from the proximal to the distal conjunction. In the slow pathway, an impulse moving antigradely collides with an impulse traveling retrogradely from the fast pathway. However, the impulse cannot circulate via the reentry loop because there is a refractory period during which the depolarized tissue is not excitable. Circulation of impulses in the reentry loop is triggered by an extrasystole. The extrasystole occurs when the fast pathway is still in its refractory period. The impulse spreads anterograde through the slow pathway, exiting the refractory period. Then, it moves retrograde via the fast pathway. The impulse exits the reentry loop in proximal and distal directions. Triggered activity results from premature activation of cardiomyocytes by after-depolarizations. An after-depolarization is a depolarization that occurs during or after the repolarization phase. After-depolarizations are classified as early if they occur within phases 2 and 3, or delayed if they occur within phase 4. It is important to note that triggered activity can induce reentry mechanisms of tachyarrhythmias. Early after-depolarizations are due to the opening of L-type calcium channels and may be contributed by a prolonged QT interval, bradycardia, hypoxia, acidosis, and hypokalemia. Delayed after-depolarizations are caused by intercellular calcium overload, which may be contributed by ischemia, hypercalcemia, and the effect of digoxin. Thank you for watching this video. Please like and subscribe.